You heated up a tin of food and ate it from the pan with a spoon at your window. The clock ticked. The birds on the wire flew away, one by one. The last bird lingered, as if deciding whether it would try your birdseed packet, but then joined its companions. You lit a lucky strike and slowly smoked it in the shadows, down to the end. The man's light went off. Had he gone somewhere, or was he sitting there? Was he smoking, in the flicker of a game show with muted sound, like you? The hourly bus passed below, empty, and turned right to trundle up Main Street towards the other high-rise. Suddenly, you think you see, there in the high-rise, nestled at the skyline, the shape of the man in the shadows of his window. You wave, but he doesn't wave back, because the view between the two of you is only one way. His shape behind the window is yours to enjoy, but his view of you is blocked, for he never has thought about the mile of air between you, and the traffic lights are lonely where you live. You should leave this town and start again, but that would be so tiring and large and complicated. You should have done this and that and made other moves, but you didn't. Those who lag behind will be beaten, said the big man. Have you seen your stars in the papers today? You'll forget them by tomorrow, but you may as well look. So you do look. And you know what? They aren't bad at all, Pippa Vale.